Hello and welcome to the Tuesday stream. Tonight is the part two of insects. As last time, I will use 20 minutes on each of them and try and grind through as many as possible. Let's see, what else is there? Is there any announcements? Not really. So let's just get started. I have quite a few to get through today, so... hold on. Couple of things I need to do before. Yeah, okay. So let's get started. 20 minutes on each. Sure that I have the right pen. Yeah. Great. So 20 minutes and we'll start on this one. So once again, I have not warmed up. But this will be my warm up. So it shouldn't be too big an issue. I'm really happy that that I don't have to do skulls anymore. They were starting to get a little bit annoying. See, this goes over. This plane comes. So I'm looking at the planes of it in order to try and get it into perspective. Goes in over. Slow down. Start you my bunny, I'm your clock from After that, I think I will quickly clean my display. See, this goes up to around here. There, and then this kind of like sticks over and goes up. Behind here, and the same here, and that's then where we have this. Same over here. So far, I'm actually liking this this big or a very long arc challenge. It really helps that you know what is going to be for each day. I can definitely see improvement, and it's things that I wouldn't necessarily draw, so that of course helps as well. Marking off some of this to make it round. Also, even tried to get my my daughter to do this test, but so far no cigar. I'm cutting away some of this because it should be hidden behind, and right now it looks like it's a little too flat. detail that I know would be there that you can't see because it's in color instead of in sketch. That looks too bad. I have to figure something out while I'm adding these other details. And behind here, you can see the rest of the front. You can see like one of the legs. Here, 9 minutes left on that one. Hairs. This is out of focus, so I can really see the detailing on it. And the same here. That there is light here. And this comes back here. Some of this, one of these other legs can be seen there. And there is this tuft of hairs sticking out here. Same here. better perspective. See a little bit of this eye here. And then apart from this, these highlights in the back, everything is in shadow. So this is in shadow because it's on the other side of the head. So now I'm looking at the planes and how they are affected by the light. Okay, so that was basically that one. Maybe add a little more details where we can. But in general, this should be enough for this one. Give this a little bit of texture. Big. quickly look at which things are on top of other things and then give them a little thicker edge. Just so that they stand out. And especially on the shadow side. Shade that a little bit. Those two are in front of everything else. So I'm making those, this is in front of this here. And what was that? I'll just quickly add this to be thicker, and then the same here because it's in front. Just to make them pop out a little extra here. Like that. Some of these small hairs here. Great. That was the first one. Let's see, these should not be shown. Next one is this one. Now I'll just quickly grab a little bit of coffee before I continue. Here. That will be my coffee break for today. Or the coffee breaks so far. Might have a little bit of a longer coffee break later. Interesting. Let's get started. So this is some form of beetle. And I think here I will try and make this I would almost call it a bounding box, just so that I know that everything is in the correct place. Let's see. This actually does not go like that. It would go like this. And then we basically have the horn come up here. And it's kind of on an angle. So guess it would be something along these lines. We'll correct it after this, and then the body pretty fat. And here as well. Like that. And then there is something here in between and a leg. And here is something of a leg. And here is something of a leg. And behind here is something of a leg. I'm just putting in like the main points, and then now I can start filling in. If I feel like everything is having the right proportions. This goes down, and this actually comes here instead. Like that. It's more on an angle, so here. So I'm just cutting away some of the stuff, and that means that this one comes further down here. From here, there is going like this. This goes up, and then it kind of changes direction. And this horn should basically go up to here then. Means that this have to be thicker here in the beginning, like more like that. Just take these away from the inside. Okay, and then the horn is kind of going into this, and it's split up into two. And then it comes down. And on the other side, almost can't see where it ends. And here it's like this rounding up to here. And then this comes in over. And it goes roughly up to the end of the horn, so it goes all the way up here. See, and then it goes over here. So as you can see, I'm not using completely the, I'm just using them as kind of like guides. And there, and then up into this one. It has kind of like this rounding. Then follows this line. And the other one that goes in over, because it has like a shape. Just get rid of internals here, and it then meets up here in the end, which is roughly where that one is. Now we can this one. See, 12 minutes left on this one. So this goes down, and then there is this bubble. Goes kind of like inwards. This, and then this is actually part of the leg. I guess it's trying to walk. So this leg is like coming towards us. Inside here, and this has to be a lot longer, like this. There. Now we can add the next leg, which is down here. We've added the again this rounding. Stone out of view. And let's see, it comes down like this. I guess the muscles that are attached. And it has this protective case. I guess that's what we can see here as well. And here as well, we'll start with the leg itself, what we can see of it. And then over it the protective case, and then the leg muscles itself. It's hard to see because everything there is in shadow. Take this away. How does this fit together? So here would be the hard shell. That comes out is round. It has this rounded edge. Like that. And here, I should have rebooted before starting my stream because my touch is acting up today. This is on a like that, and this kind of goes. We could be holding up our light. We could be fighting for what's right. Like this. And let's see here, there is also like this ridge. Like this rounded ridge. This a little bit more of an angle here. And then here, this ends. There's this kind of armor that goes to around here on this. There is this. Big piece of armor. Showing us visions of the future. So many faces left to find. Down in the caverns of our mind. Need you to follow. You can see that there is some surrounding part of armor here as well. And then this is in shadow. I'm gonna have to do the shadows pretty pretty solid here because it's completely dark. And it's the same here. Like this big marking, and here's a marking, and there is a highlight. There's a 1 minute left, and a lot of dark birds. Gonna have time to do them all, but I might just actually finish them up just like this, because if there isn't that much left, there's only a little there, so might as well do that. Okay, so that was number 2, and this will be number 3, which looks pretty detailed. So, just grabbing a little bit extra coffee. Reset this one, and then just take half a minute to check some things quickly. Yeah. Okay. Let's get started. Thank you. So this one is put together by these kind of parts. So I'll do those parts individually. I think that will give the best result. I'm noticing that some of them are bigger than the others, where those big legs are coming. And then I'm looking at which ones go over the other ones. And we're coming to some that are pretty big or pretty thick. This one is actually pretty beautiful for being a lava. And the last one here. Start adding the legs, this underbelly part where the legs are attached. See, it's this one. So the legs are not on all of them. But the underbelly is. And here and there, kind of, the legs are smaller. And then from here comes out these weird feelers. There's up here. here. Is a little thinner. And the other one is down here. It's thinner than that. Let's see then, this big one also has one, and here is these weird markings, so we'll add the markings and then make them. In first. That was the underbelly. And then we can shade it in the head as well. The legs as well. They have kind of like this highlight, so we'll have to add that one straight away in the shading. Otherwise, I would have to erase and that wouldn't look natural. And 10 minutes left on this one. Oops. Gonna be a cool one, I think. Here I also have to remember the highlight. That. Let's see, let's add this. It kind of like has a tail, which is kind of weird. I guess guess it's so that it looks more spiky. And birds don't want to eat it. Let's see. One after that one, so it's this one. Where the spike is. These. Now the contrast has gone up on everything, so I'm forced to put the contrast up on these segments as well. It was this one. On both sides. One in the background as well. Shade those in. So the lower side of them and the top side. The same here. making sure to leave some white spaces or blank spaces, and that is then the highlight. They're a little thicker, so I have to work them a little extra. Of course, these in the background, they have less specular areas, but still a little. These small hooks that it has, so that pulls. No. And the last one has kind of a hook here in between. Take a quick break. So I'll be right back. So we are working on the next one here. While the forms are a lot easier, I think it's really important to get the proportions and everything correct here, due to actually those forms being easier. And I can see that the perspective is not completely correct, so I'll try and correct that now on it. And this makes it look like its top is flat, which is not the case. So try and correct that as well. There's this highlight here, which I'll take into consideration when I'm doing the eye. Like that. And the eye is actually more round, and then there is like a reflected light on the underside. Like that. And then the feelers are made up of these subsections. And this one is foreshortened. And there is a leg here. That leads up into the underbelly. And the underbelly goes all the way over here, where the attachment to the other leg is, or the next leg. I'm treating these as kind of like tubes. Ends up in this weird foot thing. the same with these hind legs. Incorrect there. It made it look like it wasn't attached correctly. And then this hard shell is shadowing over top, so it has to be thicker in the line. And here it has to be thinner than on the top side. It's almost not visible in a way. And let's add that in shadow since it's the hind leg. Just like on Sunday when we drew any of the legs behind, they were always in shadow. Just to separate them. And this goes in over that one. Same where it goes up there. And then we can see some of the eye behind. Now I'll mark where there is a little bit of highlight in the parts that go in shadow. Then put them in shadow. Here there is only a couple of highlights, but it's really important to get those correct because they describe the form. the same here on this leg. See, the highlight describes that there is like a curvature. And we have 6 minutes left, so that fits well with the front leg. Slide here that shows the leg muscle, just like over here. This leg is kind of hard because it's foreshortened. See a little bit of the leg behind. Yeah. goes here. So these are these things here. That goes and that is in shadow. That fitted well with 3 seconds left. Now I'm noticing that, let's see, that I made it too flat. Start the next 20 minutes. Noticing that this one is kind of a triangle. This goes further down. That's the arms. It basically goes down there and here to meet up with that one. So, start with the eyes, obviously. Area. and the jaws. As we can see, it's a praying mantis. Make the eyes a little bit bigger. And then this ridge that goes around the eye. Feeler connectors and the feelers. This again, a ridge. Behind here is the collar. Let's put it on here. It's actually more on a ankle. Like that. And here is a marking of the collarbone. I guess, no, it's not a collarbone, it's like a shoulder muscle. This goes on top, this first arm that is here. there's the marking of the of the arm. Then goes behind the other one, and then the teeth are visible on that one. And here, and then there is a another one of those bubbles, and then here comes the arm. And I noticed that this part has to be moved a lot. Let's see, it goes underneath here, so it basically, let's try that again. So it basically has to be moved to here. And then that one has to be moved a little as well. Since the arm is not that thick. It is thick, but not that thick. And I see that the arm also actually has to be moved a little down. More like here. Here is the muscle, and then this goes in behind this arm. This is here, and then there's some form of muscle here, and this is kind of like a cutoff. Put this in shadow. That should split it up pretty well. It means that this has to be thicker. And this has to be thicker. I can almost not see the difference. this in here and here. And fill in some shadow areas. With 5 minutes remaining on this one, I will actually call it done, and then I'll take a small break. Just add a little bit of shadow here. No. And then this goes up and here as well. This isn't shadowed downwards because it's round, like the head is rounding. Okay, that was it for tonight. So we got 6 entries made. And this beetle, dung beetle, I guess it is. And a praying mantis. And a normal beetle. And some lava. And a horny beetle. And an ant. Thanks for coming. And hope to see you tomorrow again, where this continues. Good night and have a nice evening. Bye.